Hi folks, Dave Waring here again with FitSmallBusiness.com and today's lesson of the day. In our last video, we continued our series on online marketing with a look at how to rank your small business's website in Google's organic search results. In today's video, we're going to continue that series with a look at how to rank your small business website in Google's paid search results. So let's get started. Step 1, sign up for a Google AdWords account. If you don't already have one, the first step is to visit Google AdWords and sign up. Signing up for the account is free, you only pay when you start running ads. Also, if you've bought any products from GoDaddy, you likely have a $100 AdWords credit. Just click on your My Accounts link in GoDaddy and scroll down to the bottom where it says Free Advertising Credits. Step 2. Decide what you want to advertise and what success looks like. For example, a likely goal of a dentist who is advertising their site via AdWords would be to get new patients. Perhaps even more targeted, a specific type of patient. Success in this example might be new patient appointments. Step 3. Do your keyword research. Keywords are the words and phrases that people search on Google. In order for your ads to show up in Google search results, you have to specify what keywords you want to trigger your ad. When coming up with your keyword list, it's best to start broad and then narrow down later. Also keep in mind that you want to think like a customer thinks, which means avoiding things like industry jargon and other terms a customer wouldn't use. Once you've come up with some ideas, then log into your AdWords account, go to Tools and Analysis, and click on Keyword Tool. Type in the keyword that you're interested in potentially advertising for, and then AdWords will come back with the approximate number of searches per month for that keyword. If you click the Keyword Suggestions tab at the top of the results, it also gives you a list of related keywords that you might want to consider advertising for, along with traffic estimates for those terms. I've included a link to an extensive guide on how to do keyword research in the resources link below this video. Step 4, setting up your campaign. Next, click the Campaigns link from the top menu and then select Create New Campaign. This takes you to a campaign setup page where you have the following options. Campaign Name. I recommend starting with one campaign, but you may run additional campaigns in the future to target different products and/or services. With this in mind, give the campaign a name that is representative of the ads you will be running. Campaign Type. All Google paid search campaigns run on both Google Search and Display Ad Network by default. For beginners, I recommend changing this setting to Search Network Only because it is more targeted. Locations. If you're a local business, you will likely also want to use the location settings option on this page. This makes it so your ads only show when someone searches Google within a specified distance of your place of business. Use the radius targeting option here by clicking the Let Me Choose under Locations and then Advanced Search. Budget. Next, you need to set your default bid, which is the amount you want to pay per click on one of your ads. You also need to set your maximum daily budget. There is a great article and infographic in the resources link below this video, which outlines the average conversion rates from Google paid search by industry. Overall, the average is around 5%. Armed with this information and an approximate estimate of how much a conversion is worth to you, you can get a general idea of how much you can afford to spend. Going back to our example of the dentist, let's say that he or she can afford to pay around $50 to acquire a new client. Taking the average conversion rate from Google paid search of around 5%, we know that the dentist is going to have to get around 20 people to click on his ad in order to get one new patient. By dividing 50 by 20, we come to a good level to start with of $2.50 a click that the dentist can afford to pay. This would be a good default bid in this example. Ad extensions. Lastly, you want to set up your ad extensions, which allow for things like your address, phone number, and additional links to your website. If you set up a Google Plus page for your business, you can also show your business's Google Plus star rating in your ad. Adding extensions makes your ad bigger in Google search results and allows customers to click to call you from their mobile phones,
two things which can dramatically increase your conversion rates. They also do not cost anything extra, so in most cases they're a smart idea to include. If you've not set up a Google Plus page yet, I've included a guide on how to do that in the resources link below this video. Step 5. Write your ads. Now that you have your keyword ideas, you can think about the type of ads that you may want to write. Going back to our example of the dentist, if he or she was looking to get patients for any type of dental work, the ad would be general in nature and look something like this. If, on the other hand, this same dentist was looking for a specific type of patient, the ad may be more specific and look like this one. There is a great post from Google about how to write effective ad copy, which I've included in the resources link below this video. I recommend reading the full post, but the summary is, your headline should grab users' attention and make them aware of your offering. Description line 1 should spark users' interest in your offering. Description line 2 should develop a desire to obtain your product or service. And finally, the display URL should consolidate a user's decision to take action. There are some more great tips from Saad Kumal over at Search Engine Journal, which I've included in the resources link below this video. Once your ads start to run, you'll be able to see which ads are performing the best and optimize your ads accordingly. With this in mind, you should come up with 3 or more ads by clicking the Ads, then New Ad button, which Google will automatically rotate for you so you can see which one performs the best. Step 6. Turn your campaign live, evaluate, and optimize. Now it's time to turn your campaign live. I recommend letting the campaign run for around a week before you make any changes so you have some good baseline data to work from. After observing for a week, you should have a good idea of which ads and keywords are working for your business. If you've hooked up your free Google Analytics account, you will also be able to see what your potential customers are doing on your site and can optimize your site accordingly. I've included 2 links in the resources link below this video with more information on optimizing your ads and setting up a Google Analytics account. That's our video for today. Please feel free to leave any comments or questions in the comments section below. Also, be sure to stay tuned for the next video in this series where we will discuss how to leverage Facebook for your small business. For more great advice on how to start and run a successful small business, be sure to visit us at fitsmallbusiness.com today. Thanks for watching.